We have already discussed the base case analysis of insertion sort algorithm. Now let us discuss the worst case analysis of the insertion sort algorithm. Right, let us go back to the topic. So here the running time, worst case analysis, the running time T of n could be written as, like this, T of n is equal to C1 n, let us write back the formula, n minus 1 plus C4 into n minus 1 plus C5 into I equal to 2 to n pi plus, what is that one? C6 summation I equal to 2 n pi minus 1 plus C7 into summation of I equal to 2 and n pi minus 1 plus, we know that the last step of CD, C8 into n minus 1. Right. So, what is idea behind it? Right, this is the equation which we have seen here. In the worst case, all the elements, assuming that all the elements in the reverse order. Let it be taking that situation also. If it is reverse order, so what is the idea about that? The reverse order, the procedure, the insertion sort procedure, the procedure insertion sort must, insertion sort must compare the key element, what is that key element? If I say this is called AI, with each element of the sorted survey, that is A of 1 to I minus 1. So here Ti, that is the time for the inner loop, while loop, we'll iterate that is Ti is equal to I will be, you can say that 2 times, 3 times, like that, so on. So in this case, so what is that result happen? So which we have written here, so T of n now will become, you can write here C1 into n plus C2 into n minus 1 plus C4 into n minus 1 plus C5 into, you can write here, that is I equal to 2 to N. Instead of writing Pi, you can write here, that is I. So I write here, it is I plus, I can write here C6, because in worst case, the line number 6 as well as line number 7 will also execute. So hence we should write here, I is equal to 2 to N I minus 1 plus C7 summation I equal to 2 to N and I minus 1 plus C8 into N minus 1. So this is the step. Now, as per the theory, as per the mathematical formula, arithmetic progression, what do you know that the summation of I equal to 2 to N, this is equal to, also we can write here, N into N plus 1 divided by 2 minus 1. Similarly, we can write here I equal to 2 to N minus N. If I write here I minus 1, then I can write here N into N minus 1 divided by 2. So now let us get substitute this formula into our equation. If we are substituting, so after substituting, these values, we can rewrite P of N as follows, that is P of N is equal to C1 N plus C2 N minus 1 plus C4 N minus 1 plus C5 into N N plus 1 divided by 2 minus 1 plus C6 into N minus 1 divided by 2 plus C7 into N minus 1 divided by 2 plus C8 into N minus 1. After substituting or simplifying, after simplification, we also write, what will write that? That is P of N you can write like this, C5 by 2 After simplifying, we can also write the T of N is equal to you apply this formula C to N, you will simplify C to N, C4 N, because C5 N by 2, similarly we get the formula. Now, what we are finding here, so this is the formula which you find here. Let A equal to, you can write here, C5 by 2 plus C6 by 2 plus C7 by 2. Similarly, let B is equal to, I can write here, C1 plus C2 plus C4 plus C5 by 2, okay, minus C6 by 2, minus C7 by 2, plus C8, and let C is equal to, we can write here, that is, whatever the concept find out there, that is C2 plus C4 plus C5 plus C8, we can rewrite, T of n equal to a n square plus b n plus c. Thus, the running time is quadratic function of Now, let us discuss to the average case running time. So, what is that average case running time? In the best case analysis, we have seen elements are already in sorted order. And also we have seen T of n is what you have written here, linear function of n. Similarly, in the worst case analysis, we have seen elements are all elements are in the reverse order. In the reverse order initial, right? This is very important. So T of n, which we have written here, is quadratic function of n. So In the average case analysis, the running time T of n, where best case time is the lower bound in the analysis, and worst case time is the upper bound in finding T of n in the best, in the average case. Therefore, on average, A of I is compared with just half of the sovereign and so TI will be I by 2. So this is the most important fact. The resulting average case running time turn out to be quadratic function of input size n. That is, E of n is also quadratic function of n. We will discuss our order of growth in the next class on that point. But before that all, let us go to one very important aspect of the algorithm, that is called correctness of the algorithm. Correctness of the algorithm. So, the topic is correctness of algorithm. What is that algorithm for correctness of the algorithm? Algorithm must halt or and produce output in algorithm must halt and produce output for all inputs, that is the and to say algorithm must not lead to infinite loop. For that, we are going to study one of the aspect of correctness, that is called loop invariant. Loop invariant and correctness of insertion sort algorithm. So what is that? First of all, we should have the knowledge about what is the loop invariant. What is the looping? So this is the most important thing you should see. The properties of the loop invariant says that algorithm must work for an array. It must not be lead to the infinite loop. The properties of the loop variants, all these three properties, there are three properties. There are three properties of the loop invariant. Must satisfy in the loop iteration, or satisfied in the loop iteration. Those are, that is, so what are the properties are there? Property 1, it is called initialization. So if you see the property 1 initialization, the array or you can say the subarray A I minus 1 that is equal to A of the first element is trivially true, that it is sorted. We can write that in general definition. It is true prior to the first iteration of the for loop I equal to 2. Now property number 2 is called maintenance. It is true before the next iteration and it remain true. It is true before the next iteration, and it is remain true after the current iteration. So this is called the maintenance period. And let us go to another property, that is called property number 3. It is called termination. What is the termination speak about? It is true that all the elements are to be sorted after the termination of the for loop. I equal to 2. Thank you.